and you are able to view me clearly. Okay, so I will start. So today is it is the first lecture. I will just introduce you what is the computer network. Almost you know this thing because you are final year students and you already studied some prerequisite like data communication in your previous years, and you also know many things. So today I will tell you what we are learning in this subject and what we are not learning in this subject. That is very important because when there is a subject title like computer network, then many people may think that there is no practical and something. So, but computer network is a technology. We are not here learning about what is a topology and all that. Topology, switches and router. We are learning about the concepts. How the data is transmitted from one end to another. 1 minute, there is a question. एका ब्रांचला चार किंवा पाच सब्जेक्ट आहे ना. So friends, there was little interruption. Okay, I will continue. As I told you that we have to understand conceptually what is network. See, when we talk about network, there are lot many types of networks and technologies. For example, your mobile phone, it is also a network. Mobile phone, telecommunication network. Then, and again, there are different types of technology like 2G, 3G, 4G, LTE, 5G and all that. So after all, it is a network, kind of a network. And there are many types of standards like ISO, OSI model is there. It is a standard. TCP, IP is a stack. It is a standard. Lot many protocols are there. You might not be aware. For example, there is a XNS. X means Xerox. In older days, there was one company, Xerox Corporation. Just like IBM, it was also a giant company, and they have devised one technology related with the networking. In same way, IBM was there. IBM is still there, and they are major player in technology. So they have their own network like SNA. I will tell you later the long forms. Right now it is not relevant, but you should understand that there are many types of networks. Copper networks, wired networks, optical fiber networks, satellite links are there, lot many things are there, but we are not talking or we are not going to understand or learn what are the technologies, hardware like thing. Here in this subject, we are learning about concepts. What is a network? How it works? So best way to understand any complex thing is that we have to divide it into small parts. So we can call it as a layers, and every layer has functions. So as a student, at least final year student, you must understand the concepts of network and its layers and their functions. how they are different from each other. See, every layer has its own functions and they are different from other layer functions. So why it is so, why the it is required so ki every layer should have some different functions. Otherwise, there is no meaning of dividing the whole functionality into some parts. So it simplifies the complexity of any problem. Now you may think that ki, what is there when we send something from this place to that place, say source address to destination address, what is the complexity? So we shall learn during this course that what is the problem, what is the complexity, and how that problem or what is how that complexity is handled by protocols. So as you know, that protocol is nothing but it is a mechanism, it is a rule, set of rules. You know, when a amdar, yeah, a member of parliament or some public representative comes into the or goes into the collector's office, so there is some protocol that collector must stand to, and he must salute or he must greet him. Then on collector's chair, that Lok Pratinidhi or MP or member of parliament sits. So this is a protocol. So this is a way of working. So in data also, in data transmission also, there are different types of protocols. So protocols is nothing but it is a rule. It is a set of rules. It is a steps, set of steps. And we have to follow those steps. Only if we follow those steps, then particular task can be completed. So let us go to the first slide. So today, just it is roughly that we are going to understand general about what is a CN, what is the importance. See, why I ask you this question? See, suppose, can anyone tell me what is the job of software engineer? Software engineer, because most of you would like to work as a software engineer in a high salary or maybe in a good company, national company or international company or maybe multinational company, and you may be expecting some high package, and because you want to work as a software engineer, that might be your dream, or many people may have that dream. So we have to understand what is the job of software engineer. So can anyone answer this? Again, Abhishek, Aishwarya, anyone? Because, see, you are in final year, you should be interactive, you should talk. I hope you are able to. And so, are you miss listening me or simply you are simply listening? Anyone wants to answer this question, you can raise your hand. I will ask him. Nisha Kakadeji. Anyone? My question was simple. Okay, what is the job of the software engineer? So, yeah, Rish, you should answer it. Hruday, Kiran Lande, or maybe Nisha Ji, Rasika Vadankar, someone should. Say, don't think about the wrong answers. Actually, questions are silly questions. Answers have meaning. Questions don't have meaning. So nobody is responding, but from next lecture, I will not go ahead without, because today I have not brought my laptop. So I'm not feeling comfortable. Haan, boliye, Hruday, haan, bolo, bolo, Hruday.
Software engineer roles, they basically code, test and deliver the project, sir.
You are right. See, there are many companies. There are different types of companies. Some companies might be designing web pages or portals like a mall-like things, like Amazon-like things. Some companies might be designing simple websites. Some companies may be handling softwares related with the accounting and all that. So depending on the type of the company or their main specialty or expertise of that company, that particular, every project requires some kind of software engineer. So software engineer's job may be different. Software engineer doesn't mean that he should be a good coder. Means maybe in Java or Python. See, that is the thing. So there are on YouTube, you try to learn a lot many things are there. There is one site, Quora.com, Q-U-O-R-A, Quora. Or I will write here. So you try to be a member of this site. Almost all Indians, IITians, IISc, almost all cream of Indian who are working abroad and India, they are member of this site. And they exchange their maybe problems or maybe issues, maybe switching. Suppose some engineer might be learning, working in a TCS, maybe for 7 or 8 years, and he want to switch from TCS to some other company, maybe IBM or Microsoft. Then they put their questions here, and some other expert in same working in same domain answers it. So if you become a member of that, if you have a login account in that Quora site, Q-U-O-R-A, you will understand what is required. So today I will not tell you what is a software engineering and what is job. There is one subject, software engineering to you. So through that you will learn. But as I told you, that depending on the type of the thrust area, speciality of particular company, maybe IT company or software company, the job of or means the task or responsibilities of software engineer may change. So the expertise required for software engineer which is working in Microsoft, and the expertise required for software engineer, because software engineer is a post or a profession kind of thing, working in some other company, say XYZ, so the working or the requirement of skills might be different. That is there. But you know that all software engineers, they are involved in software development or software manufacturing. You know this thing, I hope. And then once you design some product, maybe application software or some software or maybe some piece of code, then what is your job? Your job is to check its performance, just like a car. A car has average 17 kilometer per hour, a liter. Motorcycle can have average 40 kilometer per liter, like that. So in this way, as a software engineer, you have to measure also the performance of your product. That is also a part of a software engineer job. So it's not it may be a finished product or it may be a product under construction or development. So, you know, almost all applications run on network. Almost all applications are web-based or it requires a multi-user, something like that. So performance is very important. So there might be thousands of people logging into the system. And because of thousands of concurrent requests, a system may respond slowly or may hang. So whatever application, it may be a website or web, it may be some transaction kind of thing or some other thing, then you have to measure or you have to increase the capacity. Suppose your system supports 1,000 concurrent users without, and it has good response time, means there is no delay as such. And if your customers or clients increases from 1,000 to 2,000 or 1,100, means 100 people are increased there, so system may go down or system may stop working or responding properly. So that is there. So this is where it comes the job of the software engineer. And the person who has the basic knowledge, fundamental knowledge of computer network and how it works, that is a protocol, then he can tune his application in a good manner, such a way that he, even though number of clients increasing, concurrent clients are increasing, but so that is called as a capacity scaling. There are different types of scalings are there. You should note the words, whatever I use. So scaling is a word, technical word. You have to understand it. So there are different ways. Either you can increase, scaling may be increasing the capacity. Means you may have to change the processor of your machine or server. or you may have to add one more processor, just like a Core Duo or multi-core processor or something, or you may have to increase the RAM, disk size and all. So scaling is there. It means you are increasing the capacity, computing capacity. So computing capacity is something, one part. And there is another that is called the bandwidth. So you have to understand what is the meaning of the bandwidth. Or you have to understand the concept of the throughput. See, whatever the terms I am using, throughput, bandwidth, consumption, response time, lot many things are there. So all are related with the computer network. No matter what kind of network you are using under the hood, it is just like a car. There is a bonnet. If you open that bonnet, then you will see the mechanical things inside that car. And you have to tune that thing to get a proper performance or average. So network plays very important role. I will just go ahead. So I will just today will give you some brief history and application and areas where are domains where it is used. So from these two pictures, you can easily understand this is a robotic vehicle. It may be on Mars or some may be Moon. So what is happening? You are controlling it from Earth. If you do something wrong, or if you pass some wrong command to move left or right or something, what will happen? It will create a disaster. You cannot send your person or man to repair that vehicle on Moon or maybe on Mars. It may take billions of dollars. So application performance, response time, throughput, and lot many things are there. But the person who knows the basic concepts of protocols, how they work, how layers are there, how they interact with each other, that person can solve particular problem if they are facing. So just I will just briefly tell you what is there in unit one. So typically in unit one, we are going to understand what is the application level protocol. So I will just list only 2-3 here, and I will quickly go ahead another unit. So friends, there are some protocols, popular protocols, we call them as application level protocols, that is HTTP, you know well this, FTP is their file transfer protocol, SMTP, this is a mail, simple mail transfer protocol, and DNS, domain name service. We shall try to understand what is that and why they are required, why so many protocols are required. So that is what we are going to understand. Then we are going to understand what is the meaning of the protocol stack. As I told you, there are different types of network mechanisms. Just like ISO is one mechanism, proposed mechanism. In same way, TCP/IP is one mechanism. SNA, that is IBM's network, it is also one mechanism. XNA, Xerox Network Architecture. So that is also, so lot many types of networks are there and lot many types of network protocols are there. But luckily, TCP/IP is almost used by everyone, even though they are using different types of networks, but their networks, their set of protocols support TCP/IP mechanism. That is again a type of a protocol, even though we call it as by different names, like application layer, transport layer, and all that. But inside the hood, you will find these common protocols. Then there are certain terms like network entity. So you know all these things. Network entity means what? There are the components like switch is there. In switch, there are different types of switches, like layer 3 switch is there, layer 2 switch is there, hub is there, many things are there. Router is there, gateway is there, that we are going to see here. But we are focusing only on protocols only. So these are the basic things. So perhaps we may not cover them. And we are going to understand what is the advantage of this layered mechanism, layering. And we have to understand at the same time what is the disadvantage of that. Definitely there is a disadvantage that we shall discuss in due course. So similarly, in second unit, we are just learning only one protocol, transport layer protocol. So there are two mechanisms, TCP and UDP, that we shall see there. So, and there are some concepts, whatever you have learned in other subjects like STLD or other electronic subject. But what is a multiplexing? What is demultiplexing? What is its importance? That thing. And then there is a concept of the congestion control, just like a traffic. In traffic, maybe in office hours, say around 11 a.m. or maybe, so that time, if you go in city, so almost all the squares or chowk, they are flooded, they are congested. So there is some traffic police and he handles that jam, traffic jam in that square. Same thing is here. It is related with the transport layer, this transmission of information from one place to another. So there could be the chances of congestion. So there are some algorithms. There are some ways to detect the congestion. There are some ways to avoid some congestion. And there are some ways to handle that congestion. If there is a congestion, then how to cope with that and do our task. So that is called the congestion control algorithms or mechanism, you can say. So this is related with the unit 2. And unit 3, we are just learning. This is a very important unit, unit number 3. It is a IP, network layer protocol. So you know internet protocol. So here we are trying to understand what is the meaning of the routing. For example, if you want to go to Mumbai from Shigao, then you have many ways. You can go to Akola, then go to Aurangabad, and then to Mumbai. In same way, you have another alternative. You can go to Khamgao, then Jalgao, then Bhusawal, and then Mumbai or Nashik, like that. So everything is automatic. So how it happens, that we are going to understand here in network layer. So there are some, so actually basically there are only two major algorithms, link state algorithm and distance vector algorithm, and which is integrated with the network layer. So this is how the routing decisions are taken. So we shall understand what is a router, how it works. Then there are many concepts like packet, segment, frame, byte. We have to understand all these things in this unit. And there is one mechanism that is called the ICMP, Internet Control Message Protocol. If there is some traffic problem, then there is a messaging mechanism that is called the ICMP. And that messaging mechanism, this ICMP will tell the sender or maybe receiver that there is some problem somewhere in the route. So that is notified by ICMP mechanism. So this is a mechanism actually. So that we are going to see here. Then we are going to understand what is a IPv6. So it's a version number 6. We shall see what is the current version, IPv4, version number 4. And you have to think, why there is, where is the version 1, where is the version 2, where is the version 5, why there is a directly 6. So that is not in syllabus, but as an engineer, as a curious person, you should think about it. Where IPv4 gone? What happened to IPv5? So anyway, we are going to understand the importance and advantages of IPv6 as compared to IPv4. So whatever the traditional network, whatever I'm talking with you, mostly the traffic I'm communicating with you is at least in India. They have not changed the infrastructure. So most of the traffic in India is going through IPv4 mechanism. So I will tell you, so basically there is one separate unit. We shall understand how IPv4 and how IPv6, version number 6, work in coordination. They work with each other. So this is unit number 3. Then unit number 4 is there. So this is called the link layer, or you have heard about data link layer, physical link layer. So, and you will understand why we are calling it as a link layer, why we are not calling it as a physical layer or data link layer. So that I will talk So fourth is dealing with the link layer. So actually link layer is nothing but it is a combination of the data link layer and physical layer. So here we are going to understand what is the error detection mechanism, what is the correction mechanism, what is the multiple access protocol, what is LAN. Then there is a standard you might have familiar with it, 802 point something, 802 point, say here, 802 point. So it may be 3, it may be 2, it may be 11. So depending on the type of the media or a physical medium, it may be Wi-Fi, it may be copper, it may be fiber, it may be a microwave link, depending on that. But the name of this standard is a 802.11234. So every number has some meaning after that decimal point. So that we are going to understand in this unit. So you might have heard there is something called as IEEE, right? IEEE, mere khayal se sabko pata hai. So IEEE ke bahut sare paper bhi rehte hain, jaise ACM karke rehta hai. ACM is a advanced computing machinery karke ek organization hai jisme log research paper dalte hai. In same way there is a standard, IEEE standard. So IEEE is not simply related with the communication or telecommunication. IEEE is responsible for the standard, say 802.3511G, lot many suffixes are there. So all those things we are going to understand it here. Then there is something called the PPP. So that we are going to understand here. So this unit is very small, but very, very important because it is responsible for actual delivery of your data in terms of bits, zeros and ones to the destination. And you will find that the functioning of this link layer is nearly same to transport layer. Almost the feature functions of this layer, link layer, is nearly similar to transport layer. But what is happening? They are working on different levels. So that is there. So we are going to understand what is the meaning of that, this level, upper layer, higher, lower layer, middle layer, like that. So what is the difference? Now in fifth unit, there is a concept, because we know security is the most of the important concern for everybody who is designing a application, maybe software, or the person who is using some application or software. So you require it. So you might be familiar with S, security. S means security. HTTPS, right? So whenever you land on Gmail page, so it doesn't use HTTP only, it uses HTTPS. So S is a secured connection. In same way, security is provided on different layers, like TLS, transport layer security. HTTPS is a application layer security. So that part we are going to understand. And it is very important. Here some algorithms are there, like RSA is there. That is a popular. So there are other algorithms are there. But RSA is almost accepted algorithm. Lot many algorithms like Diffie-Hellman is there, then DES is there, data encryption standard, DES. And then so I will not talk about it. So some set of algorithms are there, but major algorithm is the RSA. So that we are going to understand. Then we are going to understand what is the meaning of the digital signature, why it is required. So you might have stuck somewhere when you send some information like mail or something. So you require a digital signature. So how to create our own digital signature, that we are going to understand here. So for example, if you are using mail client like Outlook Express or Thunderbird, I don't know, but most of you might be using only webmail. Let me see what you are doing. You are using web browser to send or receive a mail. So that is not a client. It is a web client, web-based client, or it is simply a browser. But there are separate applications, client programs or applications available, like Outlook Express or Thunderbird or Firebird. Lot many are there. So there you can configure your digital signature. Means whatever you are sending to the person, he will authenticate that key money. This information I have received from particular person, that is authenticated. So signature is there every time we sign something like that. So digital signature concept is very important. That we are going to understand here, and its importance, how to compute the digital signature. So some algorithms are there to compute the digital signature. You might have heard about the hash. There is a technology, hashing technology, that is also used there. And this, there is some protocol that is called the SSL, the socket secure layer, socket secure layer, and IPsec. IP is a internet protocol, and SEC means security. So these two protocols, along with the some algorithms, we are going to understand how the security is achieved in a data transmission between any application. It may be any. You may be using browser. Some other person may be using some other application, maybe written in some other language. Now, the last unit is there, that is a firewall. It is very simple. It is a only informative, but here we shall understand what are different mechanisms available, like packet filtering, gateways. Then there is a one mechanism that is called as a SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol. So that is actually, this is an old mechanism. Nowadays there are many new versions are available, and many different ways are there which are used. But this was a old legacy and improved application, and it is not outdated. It is still used in many places, at least because as a user we don't know this thing, but the people who are running the networks, maybe data centers, they are using it for managing. See, M is there, SNMP, Simple Network Management Protocol. So managing devices. You can just imagine in campus, there are many racks. In the rack, there are switches. There are different types of switches, like layer 2 switch, layer 3 switch, fiber switch, copper switch, or whatever. So you are sitting on only one place, and you are monitoring or controlling or tuning the performance of all these network active components through this mechanism that is called the SNMP. So you don't need to go to the site. For example, the person is sitting in a data center and there is some problem in a SV hostel switch. So what is the problem? For that, there is no need to send a person on that site because it is costly. So what is happening? People are using mechanisms like SNMP. So there is some client running on that switch or maybe on that device, which is giving or acting as access point or access Wi-Fi point or whatever. And it is continuously telling the status of traffic to the network administrator or console room or SNMP server. So the data center administrator can easily detect the problems or type of the problem occurring on remote places in his network. So we suppose that he has some area and he maintains all the devices, their performance as per the requirement of his organization or business. Then there is one mechanism that is called the ASNI. We shall talk, actually it is a standard. It is not something. So there are versions like ASN1, 2, whatever, that we are going to see in this unit. So something related with the security and management that here we are learning. So in this way, we are getting the idea how the information is sent from one place to another. And if something goes wrong, suppose some intermediate link goes down or some packet goes noisy. Noisy means there is some problem in digit representation of numbers, zeros and ones, then how it is handled. So if we learn all these 6 units, you will understand how that problem is handled. Or if there is a loss, for example, if you send something through post, so it may happen that your packet may loss. आपने जो envelope भेजा है वो miss हो सकता है या गलत ठिकान पे जा सकता है. गलत ठिकान पे जाने का question ही नहीं है, वो it may be lost. तो lost हो गया तो क्या करना, हमको retransmit करना है. तो when to retransmit, retransmit मतलब same चीज हमको फिर से send करनी है, that is there. So this is a very famous book. These are textbooks. Almost please note this thing. You are not studying any old content. These are the two authors, Professor James Kuros and Keith Ross. These are the people. There is their book. It is given there. Computer Networking, LPE, low price edition. It is available in library. Lot many versions are there, first edition, second edition, and whatever. So try to use the latest edition. And this book is used by almost all courses, BE, ME, PhD, India, Pakistan, France, everywhere. So this is a standard book. So what I suggest is that even though you don't like to read books, I know this thing because you don't read the books. You just watch the YouTube and you just read something, very short thing. But what I suggest is that in this book, after one or two chapters, there is an interview. So these two people have taken the interview of the key players who have coined something or who have invented something. So for example, Ethernet is there. Ethernet is very well known, and you also know this thing. What is that Ethernet? So the person who has invented Ethernet mechanism, उसका इंटरव्यू आपको मिलेगा यहाँ पे. सो लॉट मेनी इंपॉर्टेंट पीपल हु हैव कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन्वेंटेड समथिंग, यू विल गेट इंटरव्यूज ऑफ देयर इंटरव्यू. सो दिस टू पीपल हैव टेकन देयर इंटरव्यू एंड दे हैव प्रिंटेड बिटवीन आफ्टर ईच टू और थ्री चैप्टर्स ईच दे हैव प्रिंटेड द इंटरव्यू. सो दैट्स वाई आई एम टेलिंग यू कि यू शुड read at least those interviews, because then you will understand what is the philosophy, what is psychology, what is their intention, and what is their prediction. Means ye jo mechanism hai, for example, you are learning TCP. Now if you think about when TCP was invented, so it is what, back 40 years back, still it is in use. When IP4 was invented 30-40 years back, still it is in use. So what I want to say is that these people know that how much year this mechanism or this particular protocol will serve to the society, because in society there are different needs are coming out. For example, 20 years back people were not using FB, Facebook, people were not using YouTube, people were not using Twitter like things. You will find that Twitter or FB or even Google search mechanism, they require their own standard mechanism. For example, Google uses their own file system, GFS, Google file system. You might have heard about the Hadoop and all that. So Twitter may require some their own protocols. Now there is one more mechanism, you might have heard about it. Aap log bolte hi nahi to phir bhi, anyway, I will just go there. There is a torrent site, you know, you download some software from internet. So there are many torrent sites. So what they do, that is an example of peer-to-peer networking. Lot many mechanisms are there available, different types of networking mechanisms are there that we shall see. So torrent sites are there, so you can download some piece of software from that site, torrent site, which is very fast. अगर आप ऑर्डिनरी साइट से अगर डाउनलोड करेंगे कोई सॉफ्टवेयर या कोई डेटा, तो ट्रेडिशनल वे से आपको बहुत सारा टाइम लग सकता है. या देयर माइट बी सम पीपल इन योर क्लास, दे माइट हैव यूज डाउनलोड मैनेजर. आपने कभी डाउनलोड मैनेजर यूज किया है किसी ने? हेलो, कैन एनीवन आंसर सिंपल क्वेश्चन है कि भाई आपने डाउनलोड मैनेजर आईडीएम यूज किया है क्या, करते हो क्या? आपको मेरा आवाज सुनाई दे रहा है ना? हाँ, अच्छा दीपा इज टॉकिंग,
यस सर,
बोलो ना। ओके, सी व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू डाउनलोड समथिंग फ्रॉम द बाय यूजिंग द डाउनलोड मैनेजर, व्हाट हैपेंस, इट क्रिएट्स 3-4 कनेक्शंस, 1-2-3-4 connection, and on each connection you bring the data from that remote site. Means what? It's simple. If you use only one connection, your speed or your throughput will be not that much good. But if you do same thing on five connections, then your speed will increase 5 times at most. That is there. So in this subject we are going to understand what is the meaning of the connection. Isme connection kya hai bhi? See. As I told you, there are different types of networks or technologies, and the concept of connection is different. For example, if I ring you, so what I have to do? I have to first make the connection, means I have to dial your number. I will type your number, phone number, and then so it will create one connection. It may be a virtual connection or it may be a physical connection. We shall see later it. What is a circuit switch connection, or what is circuit? What is the meaning of the circuit and what is the meaning of the virtual circuit? So actually this is called as a connection. This is a concept. So when I dial you, you pick your phone, then we suppose that there is a connection. And then I talk, you talk. So what is happening? We are exchanging data. So whatever the voice, it's not an analog thing. My voice is getting converted into digital form, zeros and ones. So I am sending it to you in terms of packet. It may have some size. Then you are speaking something as an acknowledgement, or maybe you are speaking something. So again, your voice is coming in terms of packet to me. So this realization is different for telephone network. But same if you are using VOIP, voice over IP, because this internet is a circuit switch network. It is a packet switching network. So the way of transmitting information in a packet switch network is little different, and way of transmitting information in a actual virtual circuit, just like a telephone, is a different. That we are going to understand, and we are going to understand what is the meaning of the connection. When I say application level connection, session level connection, presentation level connection, like that. So on every layer, there is a concept of connection, and you know, we have to first establish the connection and then we have to send the data on that connection. So same thing is there. We can have multiple connections between a source and destination. So those things we are going to understand conceptually how it occurs. And time to time, I will be giving you demonstration of how to watch the packet. What is a TCP packet? What is inside that? So there are some tools like Wireshark is there. You might have heard about it. There are some other tools that can be used to open a packet, to see the header information, source address, destination address, and payload area. It is just like a rocket. Rocket mein kya hota hai? There is something called as a payload area, where we keep our satellite or something, whatever we want to launch and keep in some orbit around the Earth. So that is called as a payload area. In same way, every packet has some payload area where we keep data, and rest of the packet contains control information. That is a source address, destination address, checksum bit, some flags can be there, lot many things are there. So control information is there, along with that data is there. That is called as a payload. So that we are going to understand. So if you open particular packet, say HTTP packet or TCP packet, or maybe DNS packet, so you have to understand what is the structure of that packet, just like a mechanism, and every bit has some meaning. So textbook is a single book that you have to use. Kuros and Ross, computer networking, try to use latest edition. You will get even a EPDF ebook from net easily. Then there are certain reference books. You can use them if you wish. The people who want to do some kind of programming, they can use Richard Stevens. This is a very big person, R. Stevens. He has written volume 1, volume 2, Unix network programming. See, this is not a Unix. Actually, it is something related with the socket programming, because when we talk about packet and message or segment or frame or like that, so we have to create something called as a socket. Socket is nothing but it is a data structure. So it doesn't matter whether you are using Windows operating system or maybe Linux or Android. You have to use something called as a socket. It is just like a concept, like a pipe. Pipe, you know, more symbol. So these are the books. And there is one book I am suggesting you, John Grosen, Linux Programming Bible. So don't think, worry about the Linux programming. It's not a Linux programming. It is a socket programming. You will understand what is the meaning of the client, what is the meaning of the server, how client works, how server works, what is the IP address, where to attach, address means what, why address is required, like that. It's very simple. If I don't know your phone number, how can I talk with you? So same thing is here. So as an application user or as an end user, we don't know the IP address of a remote person, remote machine, or person don't have an IP address. Person has a name, a machine has a name, machine don't have an IP address. That we are going to understand what is the meaning of that while learning DNS, domain name service. So, and there are different types of addresses like IP address, host address. Host address means host name, machine name. For example, my machine name is a CSC1. So that is also address. Or my name is a Chandrasekhar. So that is also address. Then SBI colony, that is the area. Then building number something or plot number 3, that is again an address. Then district Buldana, Maharashtra state, that is again an address. So layers are there. So on different layers, we require different address, and we require every address, means all types of addresses. For example, there is a MAC address, that is a hexadecimal address that we require. There is IP address, that also we require. There is a port address, port number is there. For example, HTTP or WWW, World Wide Web. So there is a port address that is called as 80. Agar aap mail bhejna chahte hain, so there is a port address, 25, SMTP, 25. POP, post office protocol. So it is related with the mailing, 110110. So every service has some address. So we can call it as a port address. So we shall understand why there are different types of addresses. What is a MAC address? What is, how it works, where it works? What is IP address? On what level it works? For example, IP address works on layer number, network layer, layer number 3. In same way, port address is there, that works on transport level. Application address, host name, like www.gmail.com, this is the host name. Actually, we type gmail.com, that is a host name. So this is also address. So many types of addresses are there, and all these addresses are required on different levels that we are going to see. So if you use this book, Linux Programming Bible, it's really Bible. Then you will understand a lot many things. Even you may get this book on net ebook, and there are some other books like Douglas E. Comer. He's again a giant person. He's a very big professor. T.S. Tannenbaum. He's again a person who has invented some coin. He has coined some terms like multiprocessing system, symmetric multiprocessing (SMP). Those people who have installed Linux on their machine, they can understand what is the meaning of the SMP. Means SMP means your machine can support multiple physical processors, like processor chips, microprocessors. And there is a Stalling, William Stalling. So these are books, are very good books. Even you can keep with you, or you can go through them. So these are the reference books. And this is a main book, textbook. So a single book is sufficient, and it's more than enough. So we are near to finish. So see here, there is a site, Statistics ISC. So Internet System Consortium. See, everywhere there is a standard. As I told you, IEEE itself is a standard, and they have devised many standards. I have just given you only one example, 802.3. So this is the name of numbering of the standard. So ISC is also a body. So internet is not owned by any one person or any country. So there are different bodies who are working on different levels, and they are doing their own job, And cooperatively, all these bodies are working, and this internet, which is we call it as a public internet. We shall understand what is the meaning of the WAN, wide area network, and what is the internet, and what is the LAN, how they are different. I don't want to go right now there, means intranet, internet, like that. I don't want to go there. But ISC is one body. It is an international body. Almost many countries are members of that body, and they cooperatively, democratically decide certain things. So this graph, you try to understand what is that graph. See, it is a concept that in 1994, they started collecting the mathematical information that how many people are using internet, how many different hosts are there. Host means a machine. So my mobile phone is a machine. It also has some IP address. So that is a host. In same way, this is also a machine. So there are two hosts through which I am talking with you. So that graph is telling you how many hosts are there. So see here at the end, January 2019 data. And you see on y-axis how many users are there. Means how many machines, in short, how many machines are there in the world? So you read this. So 0000 and so many 1. something, those many people are using it. And if you think about the IP4, so kitne bit ka address rehta hai? 32. To 2^32, matlab usse bhi jyada ho raha hai. That's why we need IPv6. Uska length jo hai, wo 128 bit ka hai. Hum baad mein baat karenge iske baare mein. But I want to tell you that, see, it is an increase, very drastic, very high increase, and nowadays almost everyone is using something as a host or machine which is connected to the internet. It includes car, everything, almost all devices which are connected to the internet. And that's why it's very important, and that's why I ask you one question, ki bhai, why? Now, what is the job of the software engineer? Because its job is, his job is not only program or application development or selling something to the customer, something like that. It's not only developing, but his job is also to measure the performance of his application. He may write his application in Java or C or Pascal or whatever, but he must have something to measure the performance, that how your application, his application is working, how, what is the response time, what is the throughput, and what is the, all that. So for that, we have to utilize this knowledge, networking knowledge, because almost all applications are multi-user applications, which are used through internet. Now, just I am ending here. I will end here. Because I don't want to tell you what is the application, because you know you are always using it. But let us see. I will just tell you here one thing. Just you think that your network ke upar mein, internet ke upar mein, maybe public network, private network, virtual private network, VPN is also there. Virtual private network, public network. Then there is a concept of cloud and all that, public cloud, private cloud, whatever. Everything is a networking, but it is a network. So इसके ऊपर में ट्रैफिक कौन सा ज्यादा बहता है, कुछ ट्रैफिक टेलनेट ट्रैफिक बहता है कि एफटीपी का फ्लो होता है कि मेल का फ्लो होता है. सी, लॉट मेनी सर्विसेज आर देयर, सो दैट आई हैव नॉट टोल्ड यू व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट सर्विसेज, बट तो लेट मी टेल यू दैट कि 90% ट्रैफिक इज मेल ट्रैफिक, ईमेल ट्रैफिक ऑन द पब्लिक नेटवर्क. Then web, you know, World Wide Web, websites, this is application. Messaging is there. You are using WhatsApp and all that. Remote login is there. Last time I told you, there are many applications like AnyDesk or last time I have told you anyway. So remote login means you are taking remote desktop of that person on your local machine and you are working on that machine as if you are sitting on that remote machine. So remote login products are there, lot many products are there. There is one rlogin is a text-based command there, and there are many GUI type applications are there. I will tell later. Then P2P file sharing is there. I have just given the example of torrent. You try to get the examples. There are many other examples where P2P file sharing is there. Then games are there, multi-user games are there. Video streaming is there, YouTube is there, you know, what is that? Internet telephony is widely going on. See, nowadays people who think that they have LTE network. So actually that is nothing but it is an internet telephony, voice over IP, that we shall see later. But internet telephony is application. Now it is almost Google, Jio wala. तुम्हारा आवाज ही इंटरनेट पे से जाता है. यू आर नॉट यूजिंग ट्रेडिशनल टेलीकम्युनिकेशन नेटवर्क. यू आर यूजिंग इंटरनेट, इंटरनेट पैकेट्स और आईपी पैकेट्स टू सेंड इंफॉर्मेशन वॉइस फ्रॉम दिस प्लेस टू दैट प्लेस. वी शैल सी अबाउट एलटीई मींस क्या है करके बाद में. इट्स नॉट राइट नाउ राइट टू टॉक अबाउट इट. देन रियल टाइम वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग आई एम डूइंग विथ यू एंड पैरेलल कंप्यूटिंग इज देयर बिकॉज देयर इज अ कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्लस्टरिंग. There might be one server in Mumbai, there might be 10 servers in Pune, there might be 5 servers in Sri Lanka, and 3 servers in USA. All these servers are interconnected through internet links, and they work as a single machine. That is called as a clustering. So it is not directly, I'm not telling you what is a... किसी को कुछ पूछना है? मैं ही बड़बड़ कर रहा हूँ. तो एनी वे यू गॉट वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू से बिकॉज गूगल हैज़ टू प्लेस इज सर्वर्स एवरीवेयर इन ऑलमोस्ट ऑल बिग सिटीज लाइक बेंगलोर मुंबई एंड ऑल दैट टू सर्व देयर क्लाइंट्स इन बेटर वे. सो द सर्वर्स आर नॉट ऑपरेटिंग इंडिपेंडेंटली, दे आर ऑपरेटिंग कोऑपरेटिवली. किसी को कुछ पूछना है तो पूछ सकते हैं, क्योंकि टुडे आई एम द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम यूजिंग माय केबिन मशीन एंड माय फोन टू टॉक विथ यू. अगर आपको कुछ इसमें गड़बड़ आती है तो हृदयराज जी और कोई तो भी मुझे स्क्रीनशॉट भेज दीजिए इसके, मतलब मुझे पता चलेगा कि क्या हो रहा है करके. तो so these are the applications, lot many applications are there. I have not listed them, but you know, in COVID the whatever the vaccine management or bed management in hospitals and all that, so you know the importance of internet. So as an engineer, it's your job, it's prime that you should at least know the basic things, how it operates, how it works, how traffic or data is sent from one place to another through different services. So I will talk about what is the meaning of the service later, but there is a concept of service, means FTP service, telnet service, HTTP service, like that, mail service. So everything has some service, and every service has some number, like FTP 21, telnet 23, HTTP 80. So every service has some number. So that we shall see why there is a number. So actually this number is nothing but it's actually port number. So friends, I am ending here. Thank you very much. Tomorrow I will tell you what we are not learning in CN. So sorry for too much. So I am closing here. Thank you. लेकिन आप मुझे